All right, everyone, so in today's video, I'll be looking at potential breakouts for AFL Fantasy 2020. This should be just a quick video. I'll be naming 5 players that you should consider putting in your team. And in the next video, I'll be doing a team update for my fit for February. So, yeah, I made pretty much lots of changes, so I'll get excited for that. So, yeah, I'll let you get straight into the potential breakouts. These are pretty obvious ones, and I'm just going to be naming 5 players that have the best chance at breaking out for this year. So, let's get straight into the first one. So, we've got Andrew Brayshaw. Now, the main reason for him to break out was the midfield time. Last year, he did have like a game where he like scored like 100, I think, against St Kilda, and he was playing proper mid, so that is good signs. Obviously, we need to check the March games to see if his role is confirmed in the midfield. There's not much other players like fighting for the free mid. It's just Nat Fyfe, and David Money's injured, so that's good signs for Brayshaw, but yeah, good signs, and yeah, that's why he's going to break out midfield. Next, we got Jordan Dawson. Now, yeah, first half of the season, he was playing the wing, and his scoring was up and down, just pretty inconsistent. But now he switched roles with Jake Lloyd, and we saw what Jake Lloyd did in that role. So Jordan Dawson is going to be playing back, and we've seen that his scores have just completely lifted, and his price is pretty high now due to that. But I reckon he will even break out even more if he has a consistent back score. He will probably average 100 if he scores like that. Obviously, this has taken a big toll on Jake Lloyd. He's gone to the wing, and yeah, he's scoring. He hasn't been able to hit a ton for the last 4 games, I think. But yeah, that's why I'm not picking Jake Lloyd. And Jordan Dawson, he should thrive with the plus sixes. So yeah. Next, we've got Dan Houston. Now, obviously, it's the same with Andrew Brayshaw in midfield, but I reckon he's even better. He scored like 137 against, I think, Essendon, and yeah, that was when he just played pure mid. And yeah, we need to check Marsh once again to see if his role is confirmed. But it looks like he will be playing midfield. And yeah, if he does, then you should just lock him into your fence. Like, everyone's going to have him, so yep. And then next, we got Scott Lysett. He's going to be playing solo rock. We've seen when he wasn't playing with Paddy Ryder with those 3 games, he scored like 130 plus for those 3 games. So with his whole season without Paddy Ryder, obviously he got traded to St Kilda. He should be able to average at least 95 plus. And yeah, even with Pete Adams, we saw what happened when he was just rucking by himself with versing Todd Goldstein. Yeah, he got absolutely destroyed. So I don't think Pete Adams will be doing in the ruck a lot, and he'll just be playing a bit forward. But yeah, Scott Lysett should solo ruck, and yeah, should get 95 plus. And lastly, we got Hunter Clark. Now, his last year last year when he came back from injury, he was just going crazy, like 90, like 3 tons in a row. Yeah, everyone started to pick him up and get him in. But now this year, if he has a consistent season in the back, then he should be able to average 95 plus. And yeah, I'm very concerned to put him in my team and switching him out for Brady Smith. But obviously, we need to check role to see if he's still playing in the back. But I reckon he'll still be playing. The new coach, because I'm pretty sure I forgot his name. The new coach said that he's excited to see what Hunter Clark can still do in that role. So I'll be saying that he'll be doing the same role, and yeah, it should continue what he did in 2019. And yeah, that's basically all the breakouts I have. Leave down below if I missed anyone, and I'll make sure to cover in the next one. But hopefully you enjoyed this video. But hope to see you next one. Look forward to my team update. And yeah, thanks for the support. Like, subscribe, comment, and I hope to see you next one. Peace.